from northern part of Kerala, colloquially called Malabar. My family is basically agrarian based, and I have a graduation in engineering, and I completed it in 2016. I have made it in electronics and instrumentation, and thereafter that I started preparing for the UPSC exam. Now I just cleared CPF. I've gone through prelims, but I couldn't clear it. That's all about.
Yes, you have completed your BTEC in 2016.
Yes.
After that, you started preparing for civil services.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Then, like, how you come to know about this CAPF exam?
One of my seniors told me that this is very much, I mean, similar to the UPSC exam. I mean, the process is very much similar. So I thought it would be a better option that we would be preparing for the same exam also.
So that senior is in
CAPF only? No, he was he's an IB right now.
He's an IB right
now.
You have given CSM as your first choice?
Yes, sir.
Why CSM?
Sir, I think that I have a background in engineering. So I think it would be better aligned with the CASF rather than going for any other force. And also from my seniors, I got to know that it would be better to choose, I mean, CASF in the case of if you are going for a better family life and all. I am already ready to join any forces. But even when I am given a preference, I will go for CASF with the first.
When CASF was established, what is the motto of CASF, and who's the current director general of CASF?
CASF was established in 1969. Motto is protection and security.
Sorry.
I couldn't hear it.
Who is the current director?
It's Rajesh Ranjan, I think, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Sir,
electronics?
Yeah, I have done a graduation in electronics and instrumentation, sir.
My question is, can you differentiate between electronics and electricals?
Okay. Electricals are mainly associated with high power voltage, I mean high voltage, I mean just like the transmission of electricity. Mm-hmm. And electronics is mostly concerned with the low power electricity. That means what we deal with laptops, computers, mobiles. There will be dealing with a lot of chips there. At the same time, in electricals, we'll be dealing with high voltage or power electronics there. Conductors actually they will conduct electricity. Mm-hmm. At the same time, insulators are the opposite pole of the same. Mm-hmm. And semiconductors come in between that. We can dop it to form a semiconductor, I mean, more conductor.
Can you give us some example of insulators, semiconductors, and conductors?
Okay, sir. Conductors means steel, I mean, iron is a conductor. At the same time, silicon is a semiconductor. Mm-hmm. And then, I mean, insulators are, I mean, wood is an insulator.
Can you tell us something about this
Sabarimala
judgment?
Okay,
Sabarimala
judgment
came. Sabarimala temple, the deity, the judgment by the Apex Court, why the government was reluctant to implement the judgment?
Okay, Sabarimala judgment came in 2018 last year. Mm-hmm. And after the deity is the Ayyappa, Lord Ayyappa. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people from Tamil Nadu, I mean, even Andhra is coming from a lot of places to see Ayyappa. And, get his get the prayers and all, and after the the Sabarimala verdict came, a lot of riots happened in recent areas, the areas all over Kerala. I mean, it was between those people who were against the verdict and also supporting the verdict. The government was in support of the verdict, so they tried to implement it, but at the same time there were a lot of people who were not, I mean, they were against that, so they were actually trying to resist the government. So that created a lot of mess there, a lot of problems there, sir.
During elections, the Honorable Prime Minister has said that, like, the state was failed to protect the religious right of the state with respect to the Sabarimala temple.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so how do you see this statement of the Honorable Prime Minister?
Sir, actually, there's a right to religion for everyone. That's embodied in our constitution itself. But at the same time, whenever a particular conflict happens or particular riot happens in a particular area, there's a state government's responsibility to, I mean, turn it into a calm area. So in that case, it was, I think, the government, I mean, state government was a bit failure. So in that manner only I could see the statement.
What is judicial activism?
Judicial activism is whenever the constitution is written, whenever it go beyond a particular area, particular words are just like expressed in a way, but the same happens when judicial activism comes, that whenever it goes a bit changed, just like we have a right to education or right to particular area, at the same time whenever it is being violated or it is being changed, the Supreme Court will be taking a decision which is a bit different from that of the original one. So it could be just seen as that Supreme Court or our apex court has a very much influence in our fundamental rights.
This judgment of Supreme Court, don't you think it is an instance of judicial activism? Like fundamental, like right to protest in India is not fundamental right.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if Supreme Court is intervening in this right, don't you think it is an instance of judicial activism?
Sir, in case of Shabrimala, it is right to religion is there. So people want to worship a particular deity, and they were following a particular customs and tradition there. So whenever there will be a change in a particular tradition and custom, people may be skeptical about that, and they find it very difficult to accept it. That created all the mess there, what happened in Kerala. So, whenever time changes, the society has to change. So actually, Supreme Court made that verdict in the manner that everyone, not only men but also women, also have the right to worship Lord Ayyappa. So in that, we can say it is an act of judicial activism, sir.
Last year, we have seen
flood
condition in Kerala.
Yes.
And last year also, we have seen in Chennai.
Oh yeah.
So why like such situations are happening in some part of the country, whereas earlier it never used to be like this?
There's a lot to say about the climate change also. Due to the climate change, heavy cloudbursts happening in all parts of India. So that's also a reason. Along with that, dam management is also a reason for the floods in Kerala. Along with cloudbursts, actually accelerated the disaster.
Mr.
Shashi
Thuru.
Yes.
Is the National Public Sponsor?
He's from Trivandrum.
Can you tell us something about Mr.
Shashi Tharoor is a global man, and he used to make talks in TED, and he was once ambassador, worked with the UN, and even contested for the UN chief secretary post, but later he withdrew from it. He has written a lot of books also.
Can you name any three books written by Shashi
Tharoor? I remember one name, that's Why I Am a Hindu. That's also. Don't remember the much names.
So Jayesh?
Yes, sir.
If you talk about Western Ghats. Western Ghats.
Western Ghats.
But Western Ghats are escarpment. They are said as escarpment. So what is the escarpment? What is the meaning of escarpment? They are termed as escarpment.
Surya.
They are known as escarpment.
Okay. Sir, I don't know that term.
You know that?
Now,
this Western Ghats, Kerala forms a part of
hotspot. Yeah.
What's the meaning of this
hotspot? Sir, I believe that hotspot is an area which is very ecologically diverse, and it is also very, very, very much sensitive. So if we are not caring that area, it would be affecting the people and the ecosystem there heavily, and we will be losing a lot of diversity there. So
just to preserve this particular region, we have to
this particular
campus.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Now,
Climate change is a phenomenon that happens all of the time. But whenever our natural resources are being depleted in a drastic manner, it would happen in very soon. So, it's our need to procrastinate it. So, that we are doing with our Paris Agreement and all. We are done with sort of nationally determined contributions. So whenever we are just achieving that, it would be able to procrastinate the climate change.
So what are the major culprit gases which actually lead to climate change?
Greenhouse gases are there, sir.
Which are
the methane is there, carbon dioxide is there, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide are there. So even water vapor is also there.
You might have heard about the slogan known as Make in India.
Make in India.
So in this, we are having a product you can say that is known as T18. Sir. You know T18? T4 Tiger 18 number?
No, sir, I don't know, sir.
You don't know about this particular product?
No, sir.
Now, again, we are having a number of companies which are going to introduce hybrid cars. So, what are these hybrid cars?
Sir, hybrid cars are whenever we go away with the petroleum, we can't depend upon petroleum much, coal much, because of the thermal emissions and all. So whenever we will be turning towards the electric vehicles, we make sort of hybrid vehicles running on electricity.
So they will only go over the electricity? Sir, only go over the electricity?
Sir, I am not sure about that.
Not about the diesel car?
I mean,
it's not linked to petrol or diesel?
Sir, I'm not sure about that.
Now, one more thing. We also have a concept with regard to that is carbon sink.
Carbon sink. Yes.
So, what is carbon sink? Have you any idea?
Actually, that term is not familiar to me. I'm not. But I'm not that familiar with carbon sink. I've heard about carbon credits and all, but I'm not.
How many wildlife sinks are there in Kerala?
So I don't have the exact
national
number.
Park?
Five national, six national parks.
Which are these national parks?
Silent Valley National Park is there. It's in Palakkad. Then five national parks are located in the same district. It's called Idukki. I try to name them. It's Madikattan Chola, Anamudi Chola, Iravikulam National Park, Pampadam Chola. I'm not sure about the other name.
Palakkad
pass.
Yes. Okay.
Now, this pass will have the movement of a river. Which
river is this? I'm not sure, sir. I don't
know. You know Konkan River?
Konkan, I know. Now, why is railway stopped?
Actually, it's been tunneled. I mean, most of the parts are being tunneled. So they're in the, caves and all. They'll be just tunneling in through the caves, and they have done that railway. It's a marvelous work.
So have you heard about this Fenny cyclone?
Yes.
Fenny cyclone. Now, where is the second developed?
It was developed in the southern Bay of Bengal.
So, it is possible to have any impact of cyclones over the coastal region of Kerala?
Primarily, it was thought to be providing sort of changes, but later it shifted the course. So, because of the shift of course, we were not much affected.
In general, of course, not okay. It's possible to have any impact.
Yeah, there are chances for changes in the weather there.
Chances of weather.
Yeah. So even a sudden rain, cloudburst can happen.
A cyclone form in Arabian Sea.
Yeah. I don't think so, because normally the cyclones may move in the west direction, so it may move to the Oman side. So I don't think it would be forming a drastic effect on Kerala's coast.
You
belong
to which place?
Calicut, sir. Calicut.
Calicut. Yes.
Calicut beach is there, waterfalls are there, Tushargiri, it's very near to my home. There are also bio parks are there. Then why not passes in Calicut district? It's a very marvelous thing to have a view from the ninth.
Apart from tourism, which industry would like to develop in Kerala region?
Kerala is lacking in, normally MSMEs are lacking in Kerala. Industries are not much developed in Kerala. So it would be even better if we develop industrial culture in Kerala. So it would be helpful for people to get job there.
What kind of industry?
Food processing industries are good.
Not software?
Software is, it's going good. Infobox and Technopox are there in pockets of cities. So it's going good.
Fundamental rights
are, it's obliged by our constitution. At the same time, in case of directive principles, that is not legally bounded. I mean, in the sense that it's supposed to happen in a, in a manner that is for a better society. So whenever the government is having much money to implement that, then only they are going to implement the same. At the same time, fundamental rights are legally bound.
Suppose that state is violating our fundamental rights, then what are the provisions that we can save our fundamental rights?
We can go to the Supreme Court. I couldn't clear it. I mean, can you please repeat that?
If state is violating our fundamental rights, then what will you do?
We can. We can go to the courts.
Under which
provision? A definition of state. And, I'm not sure, sir. I mean, I'm not sure.
Can you tell me the absolute power of president?
Sir, could you please repeat it?
Can you tell me about the absolute power of president of India?
Okay. Even if president is not the de facto ruler, but de jure ruler is the president of India, and president signs every bills. I mean, every sort of acts that done by the parliament is being coming into an act whenever the president signs it. And president is the supreme commander of Indian armed forces. So in that manner, he constitutes the executive power of the president.
Tell me about COBRA first.
Yeah, COBRA is a part of CRPF. So it was mainly formed to tackle the terrorism. I mean, the red corridor areas. I mean, Naxalite areas.
And what is red corridor?
Red corridor is a corridor mainly in the eastern India. I mean, it's located over. I mean, few states including Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha, some parts of Andhra and all. And mainly it's done with the Naxalites. I mean, Maoists are there. I mean, they are actually running a parallel government in a lot of places in Red Corridor. So,
what is the concept of nationalism?
Whenever state or state of that region is not doing the exact things what people desire, they are forming a sort of kind of parallel governments there. So that parallel governments are ruling there.
What basic concept of nationalism?
Nationalism was developed in Bengal. So it was developed in Naxalbari district of Bengal. It was against the government. Whenever government goes, flop in any particular areas, people are just rioting against the government in the manner that they need to achieve that. So they are recruited in that manner. I mean, they are even providing training to work against the government and. Also the Naxalism. This happens in all pockets of every country. This happens, so it's not. I'm not saying that it's natural.
The government is lacking to prevent this.
Especially in the Red Corridor, the.
If you can leave the Red Corridor, I'm asking about the militant activities and militancy. We have army, we have forces, we have police forces. Then where government is lacking.
Maybe some lack of intelligence operation, at least in some point of time. Whenever we lack some intelligence information, the kind of terror attacks can happen. Otherwise, we are many of the attacks are being rejected because of the lack of intelligence. So, in some cases, the failure may happen. Yeah, I do support, sir.
Yes.